in what is turning out to be the feel-good moment of the year. FBI Director James Comey appears to have been under the impression that he was being pranked when he learned he was being fired from his cushy job as FBI Director by President Donald Trump. This incompetent boob was about to speak to FBI agents at the Los Angeles Bureau FBI recruiting station in Hollywood, California when he learned from national TV reports that President Trump had made the long overdue decision to terminate him from his position as director of the Federal Bureau of Investigation. Sources present at the time say Comey was surprised by the news his career was over, but still kept jabbering to the agents until he was taken to another room to meet with his aides, probably to tell him to stop talking and to go pick up his belongings from his DC office. National TV coverage later showed a fired Comey boarding a jet at the Los Angeles International Airport. The jet took off a short time later and was reported to be headed to Washington, D.C., probably to beg the Democrat Party for a job. Which, after calling for Comey's firing in October, during the Hillary Clinton fiasco, are now saying this move terrifies them. Maybe they need to head on over to their safe spaces and they will start feeling better. USA Today provides a timeline of the Comey legacy of incompetence, June 2013. President Obama appointed Comey as the seventh director of the FBI. His career included time in the private sector as well as a tenure as Deputy Attorney General under President George W. Bush. Succeeding former FBI Director Robert Mueller, Comey was confirmed by the Senate for a full 10-year term. "I must be out of my mind to be following Bob Mueller," he said at the time. "I don't know if I can fill those shoes, but I know that, however I do, I will be standing truly on the shoulders of a giant." August 2015, with the 2016 presidential primaries in full swing, the FBI confirmed it was investigating Hillary Clinton's use of a private email server during her time as Secretary of State. July 1, 2016, President Obama's Attorney General, Loretta Lynch, said she would accept the recommendations from the FBI and career prosecutors on the Clinton email case. July 2, 2016, Clinton was interviewed by the FBI for 3.5 hours. July 5, 2016, Comey called Clinton's server extremely careless, but gave a news conference in which he explained that Clinton would not be prosecuted. July 6, 2016, Lynch accepted the FBI's recommendation not to charge Clinton. July 7, 2016, Comey appeared before the House Oversight and Government Reform Committee and was grilled for his decision to recommend against charging Clinton. September 7, 2016, Comey wrote a memo to his employees, defending his recommendation. September 28, 2016, appearing during a congressional oversight hearing, Comey once again defended his recommendation not to charge Clinton. "You can call us wrong, but don't call us weasels. We are not weasels," Comey said. Whether or not you agree with the result, this was done the way you want it to be done. October 28, 2016, Comey announced that new emails had been discovered on the laptop of former New York Representative Anthony Weiner, who was married to top Clinton aide Huma Abedin, and that messages may be related to the Clinton probe. His announcement came 11 days before Election Day, November 6, 2016, 2 days before the presidential election. Comey wrote a letter to lawmakers saying that the previous decision not to prosecute Clinton over her emails would stand March 20, 2017. During a public hearing with the House Intelligence Committee, Comey publicly acknowledged that the FBI is investigating whether there was collusion between members of Donald Trump's campaign in Russia. Additionally, Comey dismissed Trump's claims that Trump was wiretapped by the Obama administration. May 3, 2017, Comey made another trip to the Hill, defending his October 28, 2016, decision to publicly announce the emails found on Weiner's laptop. "It makes me mildly nauseous that we would have had an impact on the election," Comey told the Senate Judiciary Committee. During the hearing, Comey said hundreds and thousands of emails had ended up on Weiner's laptop because of Clinton aide Huma Abedin. He said Abedin made regular practice of forwarding emails to her husband, Weiner. May 9, 2017, after reports surfaced that Comey had misstated Abedin's handling of the emails, the FBI confirmed Comey's erroneous testimony in a letter to lawmakers. Hours later, the White House announced that Comey had been fired. It's mind-boggling the fact that this charlatan thought he was so entrenched in his position at the FBI that the idea he would ever be given the pink slip and escorted out of the building by security never even crossed his arrogant little mind. Especially after the poor job he's been doing there for so long. This is the mentality of the government worker. They are paid to serve the public but know it's not easy to be let go. This needs to change.
Please do not forget to subscribe and like and comment because we want to hear your voice and thank you for watching.